Hello, my name is Ankit Khadija. I'm a postdoc at the University of Copenhagen, and I'll be presenting our work on understanding users' knowledge, attitude, and preference about the privacy and security of browser extensions. This work was conducted in collaboration with my colleagues at the University of Bremen and University of St. Gallen. Browser extensions are modules that extend the functionality of a browser by blocking unwanted advertisements, storing our passwords, or checking our grammar. They're immensely popular, with the top extensions having hundreds of millions of downloads. However, over the last years, a number of extensions were found to be malicious. These malicious extensions abuse their functionality to steal sensitive personal information, such as passwords, financial information, and browsing history. Therefore, in this project, we wanted to understand how do users perceive the risks associated with browser extensions. Here, we study users' attitude, knowledge, and preference towards browser extensions through an online survey with 353 participants. The recruitment of participants was done through online platform Prolific. The survey was hosted on Qualtrics. In this presentation, I'll focus on users' knowledge. Please read the paper if you're interested in users' attitude and preference. To evaluate respondents' knowledge and belief about the technical ability of browser extensions, we created 10 scenarios, and for each scenario, we asked the participants if the scenario was technically possible with an installed browser extension. For example, we asked if it is possible that an installed browser extension blocks access to a web page. The users could answer yes, no, or I don't know. In this particular case, 84% of the participants answered yes, technically a browser extension can block access to a web page. In the first step, we asked these questions without providing any information about the permissions requested by the browser extension. In the next step, the participants were presented with the permission dialog from either Chrome, Safari, or Firefox with a selected set of permissions. The permission dialog from Chrome for the selected permission set can be seen here. After seeing this permission dialog, 13% less participants answered yes, technically a browser extension can block access to a web page, even though the selected permission would allow the extension to do so. Our results show that overall, the browser dialogs improved people's understanding. Dialogs from Chrome and Firefox improved users' understanding significantly, however, with a small effect. Safari showed no significant change. One of our other important findings is that users' understanding seem to be heavily relied on individual experience with specific extensions. For example, the permission read and change all your data on all websites is used by various kind of extensions. And we observe that users understand the scope of this permission based upon the extension they use or encounter. Based upon our study, we provide recommendations from the perspective of the users, browsers, and policymaker. From users' perspective, it is most important to improve their understanding of the scope and limits of the browser permissions. We find that existing permission statements are too limited to convey their underlying meaning. And in this particular case, parity with similar systems such as mobile applications with one-time permissions, permission reminders, and confirmation on first use can help. From browser's perspective, the permission system should be redesigned to limit access of the browser extensions. For example, browser extensions should be provided access only to the relevant part of the HTML DOM, and sensitive information should be redacted from the extensions that do not need it. Similarly, browsers should provide the possibility to limit the scope of the extension to certain categories of website. Similar features were proposed in Chrome Manifest version 3 and Apple WWDC 2020. And lastly, from the perspective of the policymakers, we recommend that the responsibility of the individual parties should be clearly communicated. Users should be made aware of their responsibilities, and the browser should convey what responsibility they take on themselves. Thank you very much.